In this chi breather, we're going to talk about focus and define it in a way that perhaps you've never heard of before. Not that the other definitions are wrong, but this is just another way of thinking about it. So you're probably familiar with the Western philosophical concept that as a human, you're made up of three different parts, namely mind, body, and spirit. In Eastern philosophy, however, we slice it down even further. You are spirit, you are mind, and you are body, but you're also your emotion, and you are also your energy. And to break it down even further, or define it even more clearly, you are also your social interactions and your environmental interactions. So what does this have to do with focus? In Chinese, we have a phrase called san xing er yi, meaning to be of three hearts and two purposes, and meaning that you're not focused. So if your heart is divided, if your purpose is divided, or your spirit is divided, then you can't be focused and you can't accomplish whatever it is that you're setting out to do. This phrase normally gets translated as half-hearted in English. So we have the exact same concept in the English language of being of split heart, meaning that your intention isn't all there and that you aren't focused, and therefore you can't get great results. So in order to be focused, we need to integrate all of our components, the spirit, the mind, the body, the emotion, the energy, and even our environment and our social interactions can be set up to help us achieve focus. So as an example, our focus isn't always set upon achievement, but is definitely necessary for achievement. Sometimes we're just focused on a meditation, but normally when we think of focus, we're thinking about accomplishing a particular task. So if I'm trying to accomplish that task, I can make sure that my intent and my spirit is there, that my mind is focused on the task, that my body is engaged in the activity, that my emotions are tied to it, and that I put forth all of my energy into that task. And to add the last two components, we can set up our social environment so that is conducive for us to focus on whatever it is that we're doing. Sometimes that means being alone, but it could definitely mean being part of a team or being a part of another social structure. And lastly, your environment. There are many things that you can do to set up your environment to help you focus and to help you achieve. I hope you found this new perspective on focus helpful. And think about the next time that you want to accomplish something, think about integrating all the different pieces of you.